So page number 21. So what the dancing girl will say now? Yes, beta, sit down you. The dancing girl, now an old woman, came trembling to the court. Did you walk up and down that street many years ago while this poor man was building a wall? Did you see him? Who is the speaker? Who is the speaker of this line? King. So the king is asking that old woman, the one who used to be a beautiful dancer once upon a time. Yes, my lord, I remember it very well. So you did walk up and down with your anklets jangling. You were young and you distracted him. So he built a bad wall. So what did the king announce? So because you distracted him, so that mason built a bad wall. It has fallen on a poor burglar and killed him. So the person who has been killed was a poor burglar. You have killed an innocent man. You'll have to be punished. So what is irony? Irony is, so the burglar, the one who tried to rob the merchant of his wealth, that person is termed as innocent. Is he innocent? So now, for the sake of a thief, the innocent people are being tried in the court. All these people are innocent. You know this. This is what happens in a wrong system. Wherever the wrong system prevails, the right people are tried. The right people are asked the questions. The way it is happening in our country also. The rich people have been asked why you became rich. How dare you became rich? Isn't it? This is what is happening. Thank God Bill Gates was not born in India. Who is Bill Gates?
CEO
of Microsoft and one of the richest men of the world also. Right? Exact data, I don't remember whether he is the richest man or not. No, he's the seventh richest man now. But once upon a time, he was the richest man. So thank God he's not here. Otherwise, he might have also been cursed. Like, how dare you become richest man? He became rich because of his own intellect, because of his own talent, because of his own skill, because of his own hard work, because of his own mind. So he became rich. This is what is happening in India. Anyone, whosoever becomes rich, should be credited, should be taken as an example, like see how they became rich. You know, they should be taken as an inspiration. But in India, we people are cursing them. In India, when we are talking about self-reliance, we are cursing the ones who are the epitomes of self-reliance. Those who are making India proud on international front because of these Swadeshi products, we are calling them names for what? Try to understand. The mob is not always right. Yes, Peter. Okay, we'll talk about this later on. So point is, if somebody is rich, that person became rich because of his or her hard work or intellect. Okay? If you don't approve of his riches, you have your own way to become rich. You don't adopt that method. You can boycott that person. It's okay. Right? You can have your own strategies. It's okay. Isn't it? If you don't like my packet of biscuits, you don't buy it. That is what you can do. You make your own industry. Getting you also become rich. No one will stop us. No one can stop anyone. That is what the power of democracy is. You can apply for being an industrialist. You can ask for certain, you'll have to fulfill a few formalities, then you can become an industrialist, whatever. Okay, there is no hegemony. There is no dictatorship in a country like where there is democracy. Okay, you can do whatever you want to do. The power is in our hand. It is there. But why to criticize somebody who has been rich because of one's hard work? So here it is. The king will ask, so is this a dancer to be criticized? No. So she thought for a minute and said, my lord, wait. I know now why I was walking up and down that street. So what she says, I had given some gold to the goldsmith to make some jewelry for me. He was a lazy scoundrel. He made so many excuses, said he would give it now and he would give it then and so on all day. He made me walk up and down to his house a dozen times. Got it? So what happened? So when you are going to accuse anyone, maybe a right person or a wrong person, that person will always have the excuses because everybody will like to save his or her skin. So she will also save her skins. So she will say, she said, like, it was a goldsmith. Who is responsible? Because she was waiting for him to hand her over the jewelry, but he was a lazy scoundrel. He made me walk up and down to his house a dozen times. That was when this bricklayer saw me. It's not my fault, my lord. It's a damn goldsmith's fault. Poor thing. She's absolutely right, thought the king, weighing the evidence. We have got the real culprit at last. Get the goldsmith wherever he is hiding at once. So finally, he asked the attendants to bring the goldsmiths. The king's bailiffs searched for the goldsmith who was hiding in a corner of his shop. When he heard the accusation against him, he had his own story to tell. My lord, he said, I am a poor goldsmith. It's true I made this dancer come many times to my door. I gave her excuses because I couldn't finish making her jewelry before I finished the rich merchant's order. They had a wedding coming and they wouldn't wait. So you know how impatient rich men are. So what happened? Now that goldsmith, what did he do? He put again the whole blame upon the same goldsmith, the one whose house was burgled. Got it? So what did this thief, what did this goldsmith say? He said, sir, yes, that day this girl was asked, I had to give her the jewelry. But before that, I had to furnish the order of the merchant because there was a wedding at his house. And you know, rich people are very impatient. So first I had to send the order to the merchant, then only I could do something for her. So if I could not do the things for this girl, then it was because of the merchant. Who is the rich merchant who kept you from finishing this poor woman's jewelry, made her walk up and down, which distracted the bricklayer, which made a mess on his wall, which has now fallen on an innocent man and killed him? Can you name him? So the goldsmith named the merchant, and he was none other than the original owner of the house whose wall had fallen. Now justice had come full circle. Getting? Now justice had come full circle, thought the king, back to the merchant. When he was rudely summoned back to the court, he arrived crying. It wasn't me, but my father who ordered the jewelry. He is dead. I'm innocent. So he said, like, it was my father who had ordered the jewelry, and my father is no more. So I am innocent. But the king consulted his minister and ruled decisively. It's true your father is a true murderer. He is dead, but somebody must be punished in his place. So somebody must be punished. Why somebody must be punished? Why somebody must be punished? Huh? For justice? When the culprit is no more, then why to punish somebody? Huh? Which person has done wrong? The one who should be punished because he did something wrong. But that person is not alive. Then why to punish? Then why to punish? Speak louder. I guess you are right. Yes. Okay. So when you will be giving punishment to the innocent person, how can others be taught a lesson? Others will rather learn a wrong lesson. Because he was? Okay, so somewhere you are right, because his time was wasted and he was angry. So should justice be given in anger? No. Justice cannot be given in anger. Justice is not a matter of your being angry or being calm. Justice is a matter of justice. So if the wrongdoer is not there, how can you punish some innocent one? But this king will say that I have to punish somebody. Try to understand what happens in the system also. Sometimes we punish the people, somebody, to create media hype. And this is what is going to happen in the story also. Let's see. Peter, when you will punish the innocent person, what kind of example will you set? Suppose somebody did something wrong in the class and that child left the school. Then afterwards, will the school punish somebody else just to teach students a lesson? Will children learn a lesson then? If the children will learn the lesson, then they will only learn the lesson of being corrupt, of being dishonest, of being liar, nothing else. No lesson can be taught like this, mind it. But try to understand this system. You people are too young to understand all these things. Okay, it happens in a system. Okay, because the king had announced that the wrongdoer will be punished. Now the whole media, the whole public had got to know. Last year, you remember when Sushant Singh died? Afterwards, for one full year, what kept on happening? People kept on waiting for the person to be. The whole public was after one girl. Remember? Maybe she was innocent, but people wanted to punish her. Everybody became lawyer. Everybody became CBI on one's own. Everybody started posting one's own videos to say like she might be the culprit. This is what happens with media hype. Even the right person, even the innocent person gets caught. Okay, this is a system. It is about the social hype. Okay, we'll be talking about it tomorrow. Yes.